Hey guys, I'm gonna tell you a little bit of my story about learning to code at 46. And if you're considering, I hope it's gonna help you. So for those of you guys who are doing research and who wanna quickly get the information and move on, it is worth it. I don't know if you're gonna get a good job. I don't know what's gonna happen. Two reasons, the most important reasons. First, learning new skills that are hard is extremely good for your brain. So that's reason number one. They did studies where Alzheimer's, like people that study, they less likely to develop Alzheimer's as they get older. So that's reason number one. Number two, you're increasing your luck. When you have more skills, you are increasing your luck. So that's number two. There is a possibility that you can do better in life because you're increasing your luck by learning new skills. So those are two reasons. Yes, it's worth it. That's short. Okay, now I'm gonna do, for those guys who wanna stick around, I'm gonna do a long video, okay? All right. So learning to code after 45 and my story. So I am 46. I feel anguish when I'm learning new skills, especially computers. I'm afraid of computers. I studied philosophy and psychology and music in college. And a lot of it was reading books and thinking about like big questions and sort of like a lot of abstract thinking, what's important in life and things like that, and learning about wisdom and different people. Psychology, how people think, just learning about human nature. And coding computers were something very foreign to me. I'm the most not technical person you've ever met. And in fact, I was untechnical very long in college, for a very, very long time. I was afraid, terrified of computers. I didn't have a computer for a very, very long time. I'm sort of like the latest adapter. So there's leaders, there's early adopters, and there's the late adopters, people that like procrastinate as much as you can. And then when you need to have computer skills and you cannot get a job, then I'm like, okay, I need to learn something about computers. So that's me. So I just want to share that with you. When I have time, I like to work. And when I have free time, I feel a lot of anguish about free time. And a lot of times, instead of spending free time wisely and learning new things, I waste it because I wanna kind of like go into an abyss where I don't have to think. So that's me. I'm a dreamer, somebody who lives in their head a lot of times, somebody who thinks a lot of things, but it's sort of like dreams, poetry, writing. That's me, okay? The most non-practical person you've ever met. I am a single mom. I live in New York City. Have been supporting my daughter. My daughter is 5 years old. And I've been making money as a music teacher. I've been teaching music privately in New York City for a very long time. I made some money, did not make much money. I would say I made as a teacher about 50 to 60K a year and no health insurance. You know, so you would have to buy health insurance if you wanted to, no 401k, nothing. So you just, and then summer's off, and it was difficult to save money for the summer because all your students are away. So this is how I made my living. And then I decided to try something new, and I enrolled into manual QA course. It's a manual quality assurance engineer where you test software manually. But what I mean manually, you don't really need to know much coding. You just test it manually. You need some technical knowledge, but it's basically like clicking on the button, make sure it works, make sure the button is green. If it's supposed to be green, make sure nothing is misaligned, truncated, overlapped, making sure that the website is working as it's supposed to. So that's kind of like, that's the course that I took. The course was about 2 months plus internship. I got my first job 6 months after I finished the course, and it was $50,000 a year, you know, with health benefits and everything. My second job that I got after the course was eventually, I got another job, and then eventually the third job was 80K. So 80K, that was the most money that I've ever made. And I've been doing manual QA. It's been hard for me because it's still a new field for me and it's very technical. It got a little bit technical. And so now I decided to learn coding because in manual QA, there's not much you can do. You can test it manually, but if you want to progress in your career and if you want to make more money and if you want to keep growing, you need to learn coding eventually. Whether you want to be a developer, whether you want to do quality assurance, but you have to write automation scripts, which you need a programming language, probably JavaScript or Python. So recently, just a month ago, I enrolled into a web development course in NewCamp. NewCamp, the reason why I picked NewCamp, it's the cheapest boot camp that I could ever find. Now, cheaper would be probably studying on Udemy or Coursera. It's going to be probably even cheaper. But I am not super motivated person and I need somebody to hold me accountable. That's why I picked NewCamp. It's $439. I paid 200 and 200, you know, every 2 weeks. And we've learned in 1 month. The first week was HTML, second week was CSS, third week JavaScript, fourth week JavaScript, first week HTML. We wrote a website about me in HTML, simple website. Second, we did a website, simple website, dating website. It's actually a dating form using CSS. Third week, we used JavaScript to create a computer game. It's a colors game. Fourth week, JavaScript, HTML, CSS, we learned. We created a computer game, matching colors game. And the whole week, NewCamp, the whole week you study by yourself. Nobody's hold you accountable. But every Saturday you have a workshop where you meet with your peers, you meet with your teacher, and you code for 4 hours. And you have to submit your assignment or you fail. So it kept me accountable. Now, sometimes I showed up to workshop not understanding at all what's going on, but I kept showing up. I kept showing up, okay? I was the oldest one in my class. Just like in the manual QA course, I was the oldest one. So it does sometimes feels like a little weird because you feel like a failure. You feel like, wait, like, what are you gonna say to these people? Hey, I'm 46 and I still haven't figured out my life. And that's pretty much the truth. And it's embarrassing. So anyway, so I kept showing up and it's a good introduction course. You get introductions to HTML, CSS, JavaScript. Now, when you look at the code, it doesn't look alien to you. You could read it. Now, you're no expert. You're not a web developer. So this is just a good introduction. Obviously, you need to practice every week and you need to keep coding about 2 to 3 hours a day. So it's worth it. I'm thinking to take it another boot camp at NewCamp. Now, for those of you guys who think in which boot camp, so NewCamp is the cheapest, but you need to be self-motivated, good at studying, and you need to know some understanding of coding. Like you can't be a complete newbie because it is tough and really self-motivated. Because you're on your own. Yes, you have accountability, and every Saturday you have to do workshop and submit your assignment, but the whole week you're on your own. Now, it cost, I think the whole, if you want to take the whole course, I think it's like about $6,000 at NewCamp. Now, all the other boot camps are 20K, 30K. It's probably better. You have instructor, you code with people every day. You're probably gonna learn better. But again, I don't have that kind of money. And I would love, I wish I could take the other boot camps because I would love in-person learning. I'm a very person person. I need to see people, so I would love that more, but I can't afford it. So those are your options. Now, if you're really self-motivated person, you can learn it by yourself, okay? For me, I need the accountability. So let's see what else I've covered. That I'm a dreamer, that I was not the most non-technical person, that I got into a few years ago, a few years into manual QA. It's the most money I've ever made so far. It's hard. And it's hard to learn new things. I also have ADD. Like, I'm literally like, it's hard for me to concentrate because whenever I do something, I have like a thousand other things going on in my brain. And it's tough for me. And if I can do it, you can do it. That's for sure. And also, I'm better at following instructions sometimes. So if I can do it, you can do it. And don't give up. You can do it. Keep showing up. You're probably gonna feel fog at the first months of learning, but it's okay. Don't give up. Keep showing up. And that's it. I will let you know. I'm thinking of enrolling into Python and SQL course, backend development, and I will let you know how it goes. If you have any questions, let me know. I'm thinking about making a video about manual QA. If that would be helpful to you, I can tell you all the details about manual QA, what it's like to be manual QA, and let me know how I can help. Thanks for watching.